Though it is widely believed that hockey is the national sport of India, but the youth ministry has declared that there is no official mandate that declares that hockey is the national sport of India.
Sports personalities also need to deal with nepotism and favoritism in their process of selection, and most of the time the decision goes against them. There are many products of nepotism such as Stuart Binney, Rohan Gavaskar, Ramesh Pawar and many more. The victims of favoritism had not been restricted to cricket only, but it has been prevalent in many sports. Hello everyone, this is Atriva.
Hey guys, this is Shubhan. Namaskar, adab, sat sri akal. Welcome to a brand new episode of What's Your Take.
In this video, we are going to put up some harsh truths about Indian sports and why is it lagging so much behind. So let's start.
Let's be honest with ourselves. Whenever we talk about sports in India, the first game that comes in our mind is cricket, followed by football, hockey and badminton.
Now the problem is with two issues. Firstly, the mindset of the people, and secondly, the high officials in the authority who are corrupted. In India, we praise the player only when they are famous and have reached a certain level, and neglect the ones who are still struggling and have the capability to excel.
If you're talking about countries who have done well in sports, the identification of the talent and nurturing the talent are the most important aspects of sports. In our country, sadly, we wait for somebody to become a hero, worship the hero, talk about his old journey only when he has become the hero. So imagine if somebody who has worked the same amount and couldn't be the hero, you will not want to talk about the person. And I'm not just blaming the media, it was just a reference. But it's very, very important when somebody is trying to become something, we have to give the person, he or she, adequate amount for him or her to achieve.
This speech summarizes the whole point.
Starting with the Summer Olympics 2016, which are organized 306 events representing 28 different sports. India had participated only in 67 events comprising 15 different sports. Sadly, we managed to only win a bronze and a silver medal by the courtesy of Sakshi Malik and PV Sindhu.
Thanks to Abhinav Bindra, who won the only gold medal for India in the 2008 Beijing Olympics. The sport in which we participated was 10-meter rear rifle shooting. And for your kind information, it was our only gold medal win in this last 3 decades. Why do you think India is lagging so much behind in sport? Is it because that Indian players are incapable? Or is it because of the poor and ill-managed infrastructure in the sports sector?
And the sad thing is that in Bharat, the kushti is so popular that in the Olympics, the Bharatiya pehlwanon ka pradarshan kafi nirashajanak raha hai.
Medal to apne chhore bhi la sake hain, bhai sahab. Par koi badhawa de tab na. ना पैसे ना फैसिलिटी किस तरह जीतेंगे मेडल अपने छोरे।
There are many promising athletes in India who could have bring glory to the country if the government had invested in them or even in the sport. There's a huge gap between the infrastructure and the surety to flourish in the sport between India and abroad.
There are some more major problems with the mindset of the people. Like for example, जब घर से सपोर्ट नहीं मिलता है तो वो बेचारा कर भी कह सकता है। अगर कोई कुछ स्पोर्ट लेके आगे बढ़ना चाहता है तो उसमें उनका घर का सपोर्ट बहुत ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि उसको उतना टाइम खेलने या प्रैक्टिस करने में लगाना होगा जितना कि वो नॉर्मली पढ़ाई में करने में लगाता है, और इसमें सबका सपोर्ट बहुत ज़रूरी है।
और ज़्यादातर लोग इस इरादे से देश के लिए खेलते हैं ताकि उनको एक सरकारी नौकरी मिल जाए। जब इंसान का टारगेट ही छोटा होता है तो वो आगे कैसे बढ़ेगा? जब उनको खेलने के बाद सरकारी नौकरी मिल जाता है तो वो खेलना छोड़ देते हैं और बस देश का एक और टैलेंट खराब हो जाता है।
और इंडिया अगर कोई मेडल ला भी लेता है तो भी उनका उतना नाम नहीं लिया जाता है एज कम्पेयर टू अ वर्ल्ड कप विनिंग क्रिकेट। लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंडिया हैज़ वन मेनी मेडल्स इन द ओलंपिक गेम्स, एशियन गेम्स एंड कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स, बट डू वी रिमेंबर देयर नेम्स? नो, वी ओनली रिमेंबर देयर नेम्स टिल द इवेंट इज फिनिश्ड और व्हेन द नेक्स्ट इवेंट कम्स। बट ऑन द अदर हैंड, टेक फॉर एग्जाम्पल एज क्रिकेट, द लास्ट वर्ल्ड कप वॉज वन इन 2011, बट द क्रेज इज स्टिल ऑन, पीपल स्टिल टॉक अबाउट इट।
इन द लास्ट एशियन गेम्स, India won 15 gold medals, 24 silver and 30 bronze, counting up to 69 medals in total. The last Commonwealth Games marked an extraordinary event for India because for the first time, India won more gold medals than silver and bronze. Sadly, our paid media won't show this and broadcast high TRP generating news on cricket and football.
All the medals are equally important, but you know what, when India wins a gold medal, chess team captain says that they are not getting any support from the government and they are bearing about 3 to 4 lakhs for 10 days by themselves.
Let's take the example of Deepa Karma, the wonder girl from Tripura. She came fourth in the Olympics in the gymnastics. If the government has invested in her prior the Olympics, she could have done better results. There are more athletes like Deepa Karmakar and Hima Das who could have bring glory to the country.
Some of the prominent players and teams who have a really high potential in them are our athletics team for track and field events. In track events, we have Hima Das, Muhammad Anas, Lalita Babbar. In field events, we have Krishna Punya, Vikas Gowda. And many other sports such as badminton, table tennis, long tennis, shooting, archery, wrestling, boxing, weightlifting. In swimming, we have Sajan Prakash. In judo, we have Avtar Singh. In rowing, we have Tattu Bhokanal. In gymnastics, we have Deepa Karmakar. And last but not the least, hockey, in which India won the highest number of gold. Although it was back in, it was before 1985, still, we can again bring that power on and again bring medals in hockey.
Though it is widely believed that hockey is the national sport of India, but the youth ministry has declared that there is no official mandate that declares that hockey is the national sport of India.
Sports personalities also need to deal with nepotism and favoritism in their process of selection, and most of the time, the decision goes against them. There are many products of nepotism, such as Stuart Binney, Rohan Gavaskar, Ramesh Pawar, and many more. The victims of favoritism had not been restricted to cricket only, but it has been prevalent in many sports. Like for example, back in 2019 March, seven girls from the Manipuri football team has accused their coach of favoritism. Prajakta Sawant has been claiming that she is a victim of favoritism since 2012.
In 2013, the biggest IPL scam was unveiled to us, which resulted in the lifetime ban of 3 Indian players and 2 years ban of 2 IPL teams. The 2010 Commonwealth Games faced a huge criticism by social activists and politicians because there was a huge scam that witnessed all over the world, and it was more criticized because India was fighting against poverty and that totally marred the hard work of the Indian athletes.
Surprisingly, India can have an upper hand in sports because we have the world's largest youth population. So if we channelize our youth in the right direction with proper care and facilities, then they might bring glory to themselves as well as the country.
Scams and corruption has destroyed the careers of many athletes over the years, and it is still an ongoing process.
कौन कहता है कि हिंदुस्तानियों में दम नहीं है? स्पोर्ट्स में से पॉलिटिक्स हटा के देखो, गली-गली में चैंपियंस मिलेंगे।
We hope to see a major change in the sports sector of India. We hope that India brings glory again, and especially in the 2021 Tokyo Olympics.
Like every time, we won't beg for your likes or subscriptions, but if you find this video quite helpful and informative, then please share it with your friends and families and get them acquainted with these facts.
Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Comment down your thoughts. Share this video as much as possible. Show us some support. Have a great day. Lastly, Jai Hind, Jai Bangla.
That's all for today. See you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay at home. Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan.